We went 40 meters below the sea to turn this into this. The work is dangerous, but we're using tech and skill to beat underwater currents and get things done. Our goal is to clean up the ocean floor from fisher nets that are suffocating endangered corals and to restore what once was an underwater paradise. While these grounds are protected on paper, the government is not enforcing its own laws. That's why we sent Felicia from Planet Wild to La Herradura, Spain, to team up with an amazing group of locals that are doing what's necessary to protect our oceans. We're Planet Wild. Welcome to our second mission.
Ocean plastic is destroying our seas.
Plastics, pollution, the plastic waste.
Ocean plastic waste.
And the images you've seen of patches of garbage floating on the ocean are just the tip of the iceberg.
Each year, 8 million metric tons of plastic enters our ocean.
Most of the plastic actually sinks down to the bottom of the ocean floor, where it slowly strangles marine life
and is often never retrieved.
We have made it our mission to go where many aren't even looking,
40 meters below the sea,
to clean up the ocean floor from industrial waste and protect some of the most beautiful underwater landscapes in all of Europe.
Welcome to Punta de la Mona!
I'm very happy.
Yeah?
Very happy.
Plenty of life, lot of fishes.
That was amazing.
Most of us think about ocean plastic like this. It's a huge problem, but a much bigger one is what you don't see. 70% of the pollution in our ocean cannot be seen from a boat. It's already sunk to the floor, often threatening coral reefs and the ecosystems that they support. Why do we care so much? Because coral reefs are rare. They are found in less than 1% of the planet's oceans, but they house a quarter of all marine life on Earth. So this 1% is really something that we need to take care of. Now, when coral reefs come into contact with plastic pollution, the odds of them getting sick and potentially dying rise from 4% to nearly 90%. And this problem is nowhere more pronounced than off the coast of La Herradura, which is home to one of the most diverse ecosystems in all of the Mediterranean, including the critically endangered orange tree coral.
The corals that start here in the shallows continue far and deep into the open ocean. Here you can see corals and fish and octopus and colorful marine life of different sizes, species, and ecosystem functions. But sadly, this ecosystem has been in decline for decades. What used to be a marine paradise has become under stress from pollution that threatens not only the future of the coral reef, but also all the life that depends on it.
So what is the main source of ocean garbage? While household waste is a big part of the equation, it's estimated that over 75% of ocean plastic comes from the fishing industry, made up of nets, fishing lines, and other debris. Here in La Herradura, that number is even bigger.
Hasta la fecha hemos podido comprobar que el 92% de los residuos analizados proviene de la pesca y del fondeo libre.
This is Marina. She knows the ocean floor in La Herradura better than anybody. She and many locals have been pushing for government action to combat the pollution crisis, but little has been done. In the face of political inaction, she founded Coral Soul.
Coral Soul is the one organization that is facing this problem head-on. Marina has brought together a team of professional divers from the local communities. Together, they go out week after week and do the difficult job of freeing the cold water corals from heavy fishing nets and other industry garbage. Without the restoration efforts of Coral Soul, the sunken fisher nets would slowly suffocate the ecosystems, starting with the coral reef that has been here for over 400,000 years.
Siempre he sentido un vínculo muy fuerte con el mar y mis primeros recuerdos desde que era muy pequeña son en la playa, ¿no? O haciendo alguna cosa por los océanos. Trabajaba en diferentes proyectos con delfines, tortugas, pero siempre mi ojito derecho ha sido los corales porque al final son la base de todo. Y sin corales no hay vida. No hay tortugas, no hay peces, no hay vida.
When Marina started, 73% of the corals were seriously damaged. What seemed like an impossible mission eventually became a successful operation. Today, there are more than 30 volunteers working together to save the reef.
Todos los días es una nueva motivación. Cada coral salvado, cada kilo de basura extraído, cada pez que vuelve al arrecife porque está reconstruido, cada momento con mis compañeros luchando codo a codo para proteger al arrecife, esa es la mejor motivación que podemos ver.
The first thing in the morning today, we're here at the dive center where the divers are preparing their gear, picking up everything they need, doing some initial checks, and then heading out to the harbor.
Hey, Rafa! ¿Cuánto tiempo?
Marina is briefing the divers on today's operation. That basically means that she's splitting them up into smaller teams of two or three, all of which are going to be diving at different points of the site.
So first, we plan the dive, then we dive the plan.
This is a super smooth operation. I feel like in a matter of minutes, volunteers arrived, loaded a bunch of gear onto the boat. And now it's all packed and ready to go. So clearly not their first rodeo.
Okay, let's hold on and talk about what we're actually doing here. Because this operation can be quite dangerous. The mission is to dive down to 40 meters and more, cut off as many fishing nets as one dive allows, bring it up on the boat and dispose of it on land. What sounds straightforward is complicated by the fact that a dive at this depth is not a walk in the park. It requires technical diving skills that go well beyond normal scuba diving. The pressure down there compresses the air in your lungs so much that you use up much more air for every single breath. Technical divers therefore use heavy rebreathers that recycle the exhaled oxygen back into the system to increase bottom time and that require special training to use. What's more, underwater currents can be strong and unpredictable, and they can make the dive extremely strenuous and even dangerous.
We see weather forecast for general sea conditions, the waves, but the current is impossible to know. We have to look at the moment and make decisions on the fly.
So we just arrived at the location where the dive is going to be starting. Behind me, everyone's finalizing their preparations, getting their gear on. There's a lot of excitement in the air, but also a sense of routine.
Beneath us is about 40 meters of water, and at the bottom of it is the problem that we're trying to solve here today.
Okay, I need to admit, I'm not a professional diver, so I'm not going to join these guys. I do, however, have a different way of showing our support. We, the Planet Wild community, have equipped Marina and her team with two underwater scooters. This allows them to navigate the strong currents and reach their destinations even faster, making every operation that much more effective. I'm also still going to go in and have a look for myself, but with my snorkel instead of the diving gear.
And then the dive begins. The divers work in teams of two, each team assigned with a particular task and target area based on previous scouting trips. Once at the bottom, the clock is ticking. They need to budget 60 minutes of oxygen supply for the ascent alone, because of all of the necessary decompression stops. That gives the team only 45 minutes to work on the ground to carefully cut loose and remove fishing debris from the coral beds. The fishing lines can be hundreds of meters long, and the nets are often grown over by the corals already.
Hay veces que te encuentras un coral con una red enredado y te puedes tirar toda la inmersión ahí, porque necesitamos hacerlo de una forma muy meticulosa y sin dañar al coral.
With these conditions, it is clear that every minute counts. Right now, it's already halftime.
We fulfill exactly the bottom time and the run time until the surface. But if something happens, an emergency or any situation, we have to replan underwater.
The underwater currents add additional challenges. They make it more difficult to get to your target or react to changed circumstances. And even worse, they mean more physical labor needed to move around or stay at your working location. This means more oxygen gets used up faster, depleting the most precious resource down here, time.
The scooters that you're providing is a game changer for us because here the currents are quite unpredictable and could be really strong.
With them, the team is able to navigate the ground efficiently and carefully free up many corals from suffocating debris. Everything gets neatly folded up just in time before the signal to ascend.
We'll stop at 50 meters, 12 meters, 9 meters, and finally, the deco stop with pure oxygen at 6 meters depth. No deeper, because deeper 6 meters may be toxic, and not shallower. So it's a very strict margin, 6 meters.
Wow, what these guys do is seriously impressive.
And finally, after 1 hour of patient ascent, the team is reaching the surface again.
I'm very happy.
Yeah?
Very happy. We have recovered two very big fishing nets.
Once the nets are in the boat, the crew takes the time to carefully get any marine life out that can still be saved. And to round up a successful dive, even the dolphins came out to greet us. Back at the harbor, once the gear is clean and sorted, the team goes through all of the collected debris and catalogs it, before all volunteers head back into their civilian lives, just to reunite another two times every week to go back out again. Marina coordinates an army of highly trained volunteers, and she's running a highly professional operation where throughout all these difficult dives, there has never been a single incident.
And this crucial work needs support too. And that's why we're funding 1 month of Coral Soul's operational cost, covering the work of Marina and the back office team who do the work necessary to keep the organization going and make sure everything we just saw happens. The result is a truly collective achievement and a win for everybody.
La verdad que los resultados superan todo lo que podíamos esperar antes de empezar el programa. Zonas donde antes solamente encontrábamos residuos y corales rotos se han transformado en zonas llenas de vida, de color. Dedicamos nuestra vida a esto. Y vamos, nos encanta.
Seeing the ecosystem bounce back with your own eyes is for sure the most direct and rewarding way to assess any restoration efforts. But the overall efficacy of this work is also well documented in empirical research and reports. The tech we equip them with allows the divers to do their work more effectively for many years to come. The extra runway we provided helps them to continue operating despite limited funding and a small headcount. The ultimate goal is to restore all of the corals of this precious underwater landscape and raise enough awareness to have its protection enforced once the reef is fully recovered. This concludes our second mission, but we're really just getting started. We are building a global community that you can join to help our planet bounce back through missions like this one. In the last mission, we went out to search and protect the European bison. And as a little teaser, in the next mission, we'll plant thousands of trees to revive a massive dying forest. With our membership, you can become part of these missions as well and join Planet Wild as a backer. The bigger our community grows, the bigger these missions will get. Every member can vote on how we spend the money, see their own impact directly in videos like this, connect with us and other members through our app, and collect unique badges for every mission they support. Here's the badge for our first ocean mission. Rightfully earned by our early backers over here. If you want to become part of Planet Wild as well, sign up with the link in the description. If you want to see what it was like to encounter a European bison in the wild, watch our last mission here. If you enjoyed the video or have any feedback for us, leave a like and share your thoughts in the comments. I'm looking forward to hearing from you. Over and out.